Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. Here's some more problems we're going to work using the order of operations. These problems all involve decimals, and they also involve negative numbers. We do these five problems on this video. All right, we're going to simplify this using the order of operations. And the first thing in the order of operations is to simplify within this parentheses here. So I need to do 5.1 minus 8.6. Well, you've got a small number minus a bigger number, so let's rewrite that subtraction as 5.1 plus a negative 8.6. And then how do we add a positive and negative number? Well, they're different signs. You take their difference. So I have to do the 8.6 minus 5.1, which is 3.5. This is just scratch work over here. But the 8.6 has the negative sign that's bigger than 5.1, so this will be a negative, right? There's more negatives, negative 3.5. So now I need to do 1.3 times negative 3.5. I'm multiplying a positive number times a negative number, so it's negative. And we just do 1.3 times 3.5. And you could ignore the decimals temporarily and just think of that as 13 times 35. Okay, so I have 5 times 3, 15, carry the 1 is 65. And then 3 times 13 up here will give me 39. And adding, I'm going to get 455. But remember, the decimal points were really here, 1.3 and 3.5, so I had two digits total after the decimal point, so my final answer has to have two digits after the decimal point. So I know this positive times a negative is negative, and then I've done now 1.3 times 3.5 to get 4.55. So my final answer is negative 4.55. All right, so why don't you try this problem? Put the video on pause and see if you can get through the whole problem on your own. All right, same thing. We do have to start off by simplifying within parentheses, inside the parentheses. So we still have this negative 0.05, and we need to simplify inside parentheses. All right, so actually, I'm going to change that subtraction to adding the opposite. So this time we're adding two negatives. All right, so what happens when you add two negatives? Will your answer be negative or positive? It will be negative. It's like you're going in the hole, you're going even further in the hole. And then we add because they have like signs. If they're both negative or they're both positive, we add and again line up our decimal point. So this will be negative 10.4. Right, next step. We're multiplying a negative times a negative. So is our answer going to be positive or negative? And it's going to be positive, so I'm just going to not write anything. If you want, you could put a plus sign, but you don't need to do that. And then we're going to just multiply, right? Just ignore the decimals, 5 times 104. So you're going to take 104 times it by 5. This is easy to do, 520. So we get over here, 520. Right, that is 5 times 104. But where does the decimal really go? Well, you've got two places after the decimal point in this number and one after that. So I have three total places. So I've got to go in three places. So I don't need to write this extra zero at the end. And you could leave your answer as 0.52 or 0.52. All right, why don't you try this one on your own? Put the video on pause and try using order of operations. Okay, now in this example, the first thing we need to do is square this 1.2. So I copy up to there, and of course, you would simplify inside parentheses, but this parentheses is just to show what you're squaring, which is the 1.2. So I'm going to do 1.2 times 1.2. Remember, the easy way to do that is think 12 times 12. Which is 144, and move your decimal in one place for each of these numbers, so I'm two places in. So I have 1 minus 2 times 1.44. Right, what's the next step? We have a multiplication here. Make sure you don't do the 1 minus 2 first. So we have to do 2 times 1.44. Again, just think of that as 2 times 144, which is 288, and then move your decimal point in two places because this number 1.44 has two places after the decimal. And now I've got 1 minus 2.88, so I'm going to have a negative number here, right? So I'm going to have 1 plus a negative 2.88. So I happen to be adding a positive and a negative number, so I'm going to see which one outweighs the other, and I'm going to have more negative, so the answer is negative. And then that means we just take their difference. When you're adding with different signs, you take the difference. So we're doing 2.88 minus 1, and if you just fill in the zeros here, we get 1.88. And so that's what you get for this answer. Hopefully you got that too. All right, here's our next one. See if you could do this one by yourself first. Okay, well, we've got parentheses, and we have to simplify within parentheses first. So I've got to do that 2 minus 3.5. I'm going to write it over on the side. Remember, that means 2 plus negative 3.5. So I'm adding a positive and a negative number, so my answer is going to be negative. So I know whatever this simplifies to, it's going to be a negative number inside the parentheses. And then what do? Well, we're adding a positive and a negative, so I am going to take their difference, right? Opposite, when you're adding different signs, you take the difference. So I'm going to do 3.5 minus 2.0, which is 1.5. So that's what 2 minus 3.5 is, negative 1.5. All right, now what's the next step? We need to do our exponent here, so I have to do the negative 1.5 squared. So I've got to do negative 1.5 times negative 1.5. So I'm multiplying a negative times a negative, so is that going to be positive or negative? It's going to be positive. And we just think, 15 times 15. So everybody has to do 15 times 15. I've done a video showing you an easy way to do that. Get out a piece of paper and just do 15 times 15. Any method you want, you're going to get 225. And then you need to move your decimal place into. So when I do this negative 1.5 squared, that becomes just 2.25. I'm going to move this over a little bit so you can see the equal sign as I go along. That's equal to that, which is equal to that, which is equal to... All right, last step. We have multiplication. So I just think, what's 2 times 225? So that's 450. But I got to go in how many decimal points? 1, 2, 3 in, so it's going to be 0.45. And the other thing we have to pay attention to is that we're multiplying a negative times a positive. So it's negative. So the answer is negative. Now you could write 0.45 or 0.45. That's up to you. There's really a lot involved in working with decimals. In fact, arithmetic, there are lots of steps involved. A lot of times I think it's more difficult than algebra, but we do have to get it down. All right, try this problem on your own by putting the video on pause and then check in with me. All right, well, again, we've got parentheses, so we have to simplify inside parentheses first. All right, so what's going on in this first parentheses? We have a subtraction, so I'm going to write that as negative 1.3 plus negative 0.2. And over here, I'm going to do the same thing since there's a subtraction, 3.1 plus a negative 4. All right, so in the first parentheses, I'm adding two negative numbers. So if you're adding two negatives, the answer is going to be negative, so I know that. And then we add the two, 1.3 and 0.2 add up to 1.5. So this is negative 1.5. Right, what's the other number? In this parentheses, I have 3.1 plus negative 4. Right, so here I'm adding a positive and a negative. Okay, so which is bigger, the 3.1 or the 4? The 4 is, so the answer is going to be negative. The negatives outweigh the positives. But in this case, I'm adding a positive and a negative, so you take their difference. So I've got to do 4 minus 3.1. You remember to put in your 0.0 here, and that'll give you 0.9. So this is negative 0.9. So now I'm going to do negative 1.5 times negative 0.9. And you're multiplying a negative times a negative, so it will be positive. So we just have to do 15 times 9, which is 135. And then we have to move the decimal in two places, and that's our answer, 1.35. All right, so we've done a lot of problems. These ones involved working with negative numbers and decimals, multiplication, addition, order of operations, squaring things, etc. So there's a lot of good stuff in this video. And if you have trouble with it, just go back and do the same problems over again, and then look at my steps if you got anything wrong, and try it until it seems easy. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.